Let's keep this thing moving. Let's get to 2-2.
Kamish is taking the stage. He's definitely a little bit more lackadaisical today than on the last couple.
he rang the dinger.
Yeah. Maybe a couple of pops. Who knows? Speaking of pops.
So we got Corey up for this pick, picking for crispy Oakleys.
Yeah.
Sort of inside joke name that we're not privy to.
His name is Chris. I don't know. Bad name.
True. Chris with a K, I think. So that might have something to do with it.
Maybe Oakleys, he wears those as sunglasses.
I think he wears Oakleys all the time, possibly. I did. At pick 1-2, we went N'Keal Harry here on this team. That's right. He's got Robert Woods, and that's pretty much it. Casey reminded me at 1-2 that he had Marquise Lee down there, so don't forget about that. But he needed a wide receiver help, and he needed it badly. And we just doubled down here and, you know, just kind of bring it back around. And I went Andy Isabella. That's, for me, is a decent shot. I think most people would probably agree at 2-2. That might be a little bit early. This guy's got, like I said, crispy Oakley's here. He's got decent running backs. And if he can get something out of Robert Woods, is going to be stable. If he can get anything out of N'Keal Harry, he could probably turn from, you know, a contender, turn to a contender and maybe potentially sneak into the playoffs. It's a spread out league. There's not a four or five guys that's going to beat you up every week, keep you out of the playoffs. So he's got a chance. It makes
some noise. Lose Gronk, which hurt. But he does have Jared Cook, so that's a nice little replacement there.
Very true. Terrible shot to the groin with losing Gronk.
Missed Le'Veon all year last year.
Exactly.
So got a little consolation prizes getting to this fought and got the second pick overall.
So. Sure. So I was putting those types of things together to say, hey, I'm going Isabella here. I think that a good case could have been made if you're looking at wide receiver for J.J. Whiteside, you know, over there in Philly. I just felt like there's a shot with, you know, a lot of people are speculating on what's going to happen in the Arizona offense, but pretty much the only thing that's guaranteed is volume. And if the wheels fall off like it did yet last year, and it was just pretty much one of the worst offenses in history, then the only thing that is a guarantee there is less volume because you're three and outs all the time. I'm not saying there's not going to be a lot of three and outs, but it's going to be a completely different attempt at offenses than what they had last year.
Right.
And so everything that Cliff Kingsbury and this spread out offense has ever been is just attempts. So I put Isabella there. I could easily have taken Whiteside or easily have even, you know, squeezed in another player or two. But I feel like Andy Isabella has a chance to get out there and get some targets and be something for you sooner than later.
Isabella gives I feel comfortable taking Isabella, you know, wherever you need be. You might like Whiteside a little better, or maybe somebody likes Hollywood a little more, or I mean, you know, go down the line of other players. But if you need PPR contributions right away on a, you know, and this team could stand to get PPR contributions,
that's what I mean,
right away. Isabella, you know, is a guy who is on paper probably in a decent situation to get some balls immediately. You know, you are going to see volume, especially from those slot receivers out of this offense. That's, if we go back historically and look at what's going on with the Kingsbury offense, it likes to go quick to those slot receivers, and there'll probably be two. And I don't know how Kirk and Larry and Isabella are all going to work in there together.
Sure.
And we could be wrong. It could be, you know, with taking JJ, you might have to wait, and maybe you're waiting for Isabella for another year.
Well, I think that one of the things that makes this process that we're doing kind of cool I think is cool, because when we putting the backbone of our league here, it gives you this reason to say, okay, I can see where you can make a choice. You're sitting there on the clock, 2-2. Who I need wide receiver help, but I got Le'Veon Bell.
Yeah.
I got Jared Cook. I got guys that are not exactly.
You got Damian Williams, who could have a nice season this year, but could be off
exactly.
all the time. You
I
know?
Could, I could all of us, I could be a Cinderella championship team.
Right.
And I think what, looking back on it in 3 years, should I have taken Whiteside? Maybe. And maybe Marquise Brown gets away from a run-heavy attack, maybe, and he's the best wide receiver in this class. Who knows? But for the next 2 or 3 years, even this year coming in, this the way we've got this thing broken down, crispy Oakley's, he's taking a shot here, in my mind, for that me picking for him. He's taking a shot on Isabella. Maybe being, and again, we've said this before, this is a league where you have to have a lot of starters. And, you know, you can't just get by with two guys every week as a wide receiver unless you got five running backs or tight ends to plug in, you know. Yeah. So give him another guy. Not a lot of times do you actually find rookie wide receivers to be in your starting lineup. I mean, if you're playing a best ball and you get lucky and they blow up, but then a lot of times they're on your bench, they blew up, you plug them in, and next week they do nothing because they're rookies.
Right.
You know, so none of these guys are guaranteed production every week. But like you said, the quick hits, the slot production out of the offense – Andy Isabella is my pick.
It could end up just being Larry and Kirk for most of the season. Absolutely. Year, playing those roles, and maybe you have to wait. But I like, it's a decent stab. I'm pretty sure Arcega Whiteside's going to be waiting a minute before he gets any before you're going to want to see him in your lineup. So I think,
that was part of the logic there.
Isabella's a little quicker to maybe get you some.
In addition to that logic, too, I feel like Kirk is a really good, well-rounded wide receiver who obviously thrives in the slot. But could do a little bit of everything. And if they need the talent to squeeze the talent on the field and get the best possible pass catchers of the Cardinals offense, maybe Kirk moves outside a little bit more often than we would have thought. And Isabella's out there just to get him on the field at the same time.
Well, I mean,
fast guy.
I'm sure Isabella's going to get on the field. He's a chess piece that you can move all over. I mean, you see him lined up in the backfield sometimes at UMass. He's actually came to UMass as a running back. So you got to like that. I mean,
sure.
And you talked about him on paper. He looks great on paper. I mean, he's like the metric dream. You could nickname him that. Like, he's got the college dominator in the 97 percentile. Breakout age only in the 71 percentile, but still pretty good. Then he ran a 4.31 at the combine. Then the Cardinals traded Josh Rosen for him, basically.
Right,
he drafted
him
at the end of the second round. He's really fun to watch. He was crushing out there for UMass. Tons of long TDs. Had a 300-yard game receiving, which is unheard of. Some fun comps, right? T.Y. and Brandon Cooks, but my favorite comp was Dash from The Incredibles. That's probably the strongest comp I've heard out there.
I haven't seen that one.
If you're going to be comp to someone, might as well be Dash from The Incredibles. So, I mean, he flies off the line of scrimmage. He's fearless over the middle. The problem is he's got suspect hands and he's small. And so, you know, 20 drops over the course of his career, but only ranked 61st in drop rate according to PFF in 18. So right there on par with everybody else. If you read about him, though, it's like common knowledge. He has terrible hands, but they're probably not that bad. But if he does get pressed and jammed, it's hard for the little guy to get off of that. So he's got some learning to do, but you can put him in motion. You can line him up in the backfield. You can move him all over. He should probably get some PPR run here.
Yeah, you don't get jammed in the slot, which eventually will probably be mostly his home.
Agreed. All right, well, let's keep this thing rolling.